Okay.
Dear students, now this is video about gravimetric determination of variance. Gravimetric determination means determination of quantity of any substance present in a solution by measuring mass of a compound formed in the experiment. This kind of determination also called as gravimetric estimation or gravimetry. Now this is a solution of barium salt is given to you. And this may be solution of barium chloride or barium nitrate or any soluble salt of barium. And that solution, when it is given, it is diluted, and after dilution, 25 ml of that solution must be taken in the beaker, and to the solution we have to add 1 ml of concentrated HCl, then we have to keep it for by boiling after dilution up to 100 ml. When the solution just starts boiling, we have to add 5% solution of sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4, which is precipitating agent. When sulfuric acid is added to any solution of barium salt, there is precipitation of barium as barium sulfate. And this is the precipitate we get. We have to filter this precipitate, and we have to wash this precipitate, and we have to take the mass of this precipitate. From the mass of barium sulfate, we are going to determine mass of barium present in the given solution. Now let us see how it is experimentally done. Contains the solution of barium salt, that is given is barium chloride, whatever it may be. First we have to dilute the solution up to the mark using distilled water. Now I am adding distilled water solution for the dilution. During the addition of water, when the water level comes near to the mark, it should be very slow addition so that the water added should not cross the mark. Now I have added water up to the mark. I am closing this and I have to shake this. And by shaking, we have to make the solution homogeneous. There must be thorough shaking of the solution. Now this is the given solution of barium salt diluted and shaken to make it homogeneous. I have to pip it out 25 ml of the solution into a clean beaker. This is 25 ml of this diluted solution. Now I am taking the solution into a clean beaker. I have to add 1 ml of concentrated HCl. Then I dilute up to about 100 ml by adding some more water, say about 75 ml of water. Now I have to keep it for heating. Now this is kept for heating. When the solution just starts boiling, we have to take it down on the asbestos mat. Then we have to precipitate barium as barium sulfate by adding the 5% solution of sulfuric acid. Now the solution is about to boil. We should not allow it to boil. Take it down on asbestos mat. Now we have to go for the precipitation, which is important step in gravimetric determination. And for the precipitation I have taken 5% solution of sulfuric acid. I am adding the solution to the hot solution so that there is a reaction between barium salt and sulfuric acid to form barium sulfate as white precipitate. And once again, we have to test whether there is completion of the PPT is over or not. For that, along the sides of the test beaker, we have to slide sulfuric acid, and at the junction of meeting of solutions, we have to observe whether there is formation of PPT or not. If there is no formation of PPT, it indicates that precipitation is completed. Now precipitation is completed, and this is the beaker containing barium sulfate as precipitate. We have to digest this PPT over sand bath. Now I am taking sand bath, and over sand bath I have to keep this beaker containing barium sulfate, and I allow it to digest so that the particles become granular after some time. Barium sulfate. This is transferred with the help of washing solution. Washing solution is hot distilled water. Here, it serves both the purposes. One is helps in the transfer of precipitate. Another one is washing of the precipitate. Purpose of washing is to remove unwanted radicals like chloride and sulfate. Like this, we have to transfer the precipitate along with washing solution into the filter paper. After the complete transfer of PPT, we have to go on washing the PPT till chloride and sulfate are completely removed. And to test that, we have to take the filtrate and presence of chloride can be tested by adding 2 drops of AgNO3 to the filtrate. Now little bit turbidity is there, means chloride is not completely removed in the from the PPT, so that we have to go on washing till we get a clear solution even after addition of AgNO3. Next, we have to test the presence of sulfate, whether it is removed or not. For that, we have to take once again the filtrate, and to the filtrate taken, we have to add few drops of barium chloride. After the addition of barium chloride, if there is formation of precipitate, it indicates that sulfate is not removed, and if there is no formation of PPT, it indicates that sulfate is removed. Now there is no formation of PPT as such, but there is little bit of turbidity, so that twice or thrice we have to continue washing till both chloride and sulfate are removed, and we get no PPT in the test for chloride and no PPT in the test for sulfate. After the washing, when both the radicals chloride and sulfate are removed, the PPT or precipitate of barium sulfate is completely free from impurities. We have to dry the PPT and we have to ignite the PPT. That is next step. Means precipitate. Now we have to take small piece of filter paper and plug into the lower side of the funnel so that water draining out should not fall over the flame. Now I am keeping this over hot air cone for partial drying of the precipitate, and flame must be very low flame here so that there should not be burning of the filter paper in the funnel. Over low flame, we have to go on heating till the filter paper gets dried. When the filter paper gets dried, the filter paper along with the PPT must be transferred into previously weighed crucible.
this is crucible, and in the crucible we have to transfer that dried filter paper containing precipitate, and we have to go for ignition. And during ignition we have to take care that there is complete ignition of the PPT, so that the filter paper is said to be ashless filter paper and no residue of or ash of filter paper is left behind in the along with the precipitate. In that we have to go for drying ignition of the precipitate. And in this case the barium sulfate does not undergo any chemical change even during the ignition. We have to get only barium sulfate even after ignition. After ignition in the oven we have to take it outside and we have to cool for some time in air, and whenever it is still hot we have to cool in the desiccator. This is desiccator. In the desiccator we have to keep that crucible containing ignited residue after some time cooling in the air, so that the purpose of cooling in desiccator is to avoid the absorption of moisture. And when it is cooled in the desiccator, it is not a cooling assembly of course, but it prevents the absorption of moisture. In that way, in a dry condition we have to cool the PPT, then we have to take the weight of the crucible along with precipitate, and when the weight of the crucible is deducted from the total weight we will get the weight of barium sulfate, and this should be repeated 2 to 3 times till we get constant weight. Then from the weight of the barium sulfate by calculation we determine mass of barium present in the given solution. Barium sulfate left after ignition. Now it must be cooled in air for about 5 minutes till it attains moderately high temperature. After attaining moderately high temperature, it must be kept in the desiccator. And this is desiccator where at the bottom there are pieces of anhydrous calcium chloride, so that whatever the air in the flask, that is free from moisture. And the purpose of keeping in the desiccator is that there must not be absorption of moisture during the later stages of cooling. Now I am keeping this crucible in the desiccator for further cooling at moderately high temperature, not at very high temperature. Now after complete cooling we have to take out the crucible, and we have to take the weight of the crucible along with the residue. Now from the weight of the crucible along with residue, if the weight of the crucible is deducted, we get actual weight of barium sulfate. And from actual weight of barium sulfate, we can calculate the mass of barium present in the given solution. Thus, we carry out gravimetric determination of barium. Being it must be completely cooled, and we have to repeat heating, cooling, and the desiccator 2 or 3 times to get constant weight of the residue. That's all.